on this Wednesday. We find ourselves at 11 and a half, rolling up towards 12 minutes after 9 this morning. Standing behind me at the guest microphone, it is my pleasure to introduce Darlene Tranquilli of Living Dementia. Good morning, Darlene.
Good morning, Mike. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you today?
I'm fine.
Thanks for rolling in here this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Darlene, let's just start at the very beginning. Maria Von Trapp said it's a very good place to start. We might as well do that.
That's right.
So tell us a little bit, first of all, about yourself.
Okay. Well, I have been caring for individuals with Alzheimer's or other forms of related dementias for over 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
We started an adult day center that's dementia-specific 10 years ago. Now it's located on Schoolies Mountain Road in Hackettstown. And then we turned our home into residential care in Belvedere. We're now a 12-bed licensed facility. And then we started Living Dementia Education and Training Institute. And that is where we provide resources, training, support, grief counseling, to professionals, caregivers. We certify certified home health aides.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot that goes on.
Mm-hmm.
But what I want to talk about today is the reason we started right from ground zero was because I was approached by a family, a young family, whose wife was 54 with moderate Alzheimer's.
Mm.
That is when CELA started. CELA Care Center. And if anybody doesn't understand what CELA means, it is a moment of joy or a pause in the, the Book of Psalms.
Yes.
So there's a purpose to it. And it all started with a very young family. And she was too young to get support, financial aid, Social Security. That's how it started. Our home was started out of the need of caregivers. And Living Dementia started out of the need of caregivers. But the crux of it, the very foundation of it, is the support that we offer. So what I wanted to talk about just a couple minutes about with the audience is that we have so many caregivers out there that there is 80% of caregivers today who are caring for a loved one who has Alzheimer's or other related dementia who die before their loved one.
Yeah, and you and I, as we were talking earlier, I had mentioned a personal story, my mother-in-law and my father-in-law, my wife's parents, you know, and my father-in-law, you know, had a sudden heart attack and died, and he was taking care of my mother-in-law, but we never realized how bad her dementia was until all of a sudden we were faced with this, and it was immediate. I mean, the very next day, all of a sudden, wow. We've got to do something, and we were not prepared.
Exactly.
You know? And so you are right in that does happen. And again, a staggering statistic that in many cases, 4 out of 5 cases.
That's right.
You know, the patient who has the dementia is now going to need some care.
Yes.
It's not going to be provided by a close family member.
Not at all. And the reason this happens is because the caregiver, who knows their loved one best, who has been their confidant, their friend, their best friend, their support, is because of a couple reasons. And these are the facts. They're in denial about the disease. They can't accept that they are unable to do daily activities of living. They have extreme anxiety about the future. They are too tired to express themselves to somebody else, and they think that they won't understand.
Right.
And if I share this with somebody else or my children, that something's wrong with mom, then what's going to happen to us?
Yeah.
So they know that she probably needs more care than they're able to provide, but the loss is too great. Speaking of the loss, so this is a big reason why people need support. I myself am a 24-hour caregiver. I have 12 people who live with me who have some level of dementia, some form of dementia. I actively grieve every day. And right now, I am actively grieving the loss of one of my residents who's 56 with severe Alzheimer's, genetic form.
Yeah.
So I understand, totally understand. But the stress that it causes you, if you don't have that support to cry, to laugh, to feel that you're going to be okay even when it's over. But the fact is, when someone has a loved one, they're grieving 7 to 20 years before they even pass.
That's right. That's right. Yes.
Yes.
And again, as you and I were chatting, you know, the reality of it is you're grieving because this person is still there, a loved
yes.
one, you know, a parent, a spouse, whatever, aunt and uncle, whatever. Right. They're still there. And mm-hmm. yet the reality of it is, you know, mentally you can see them slipping away. And so you begin to grieve even though they haven't physically passed.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So a lot of people just have this assumption that you really don't start grieving till they die.
Mm.
But then it just starts all over again.
Mm-hmm.
Because even though you've been grieving for a decade,
mm-hmm.
you're never prepared for it.
Mm-hmm.
Never, ever prepared, because your life has become theirs.
Right. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to reach out to our caregivers. Encourage them to seek us,
mm-hmm.
to help them. A lot of people think support group and it's not for them. We are not a sterile environment.
Mm-hmm.
We are approachable, extremely approachable, because we live it.
Mm-hmm.
Where Living Dementia is, right on Main Street, we are a very home environment. You are welcome. We all support each other. We laugh, we cry. It doesn't matter what you need. If you're out there and you are actively grieving but don't know who to talk to, we do grief counseling. So please call us,
mm-hmm.
and we will help you. We're there for you.
Very good. You know, this is Living Dementia. We're chatting with Darlene Tranquilli. Living Dementia is at 308 Main Street in Hackettstown. The website is livingdementia.net. You guys are on Facebook as well.
Correct.
And I'm sure that people can go there and find out more
yes.
about what you offer and how they can go and contact you and get help. And even if it's just a matter of somebody to talk to for 15 or 20 minutes.
Absolutely.
You know,
yes.
just to, and of course, I mean, I'm assuming that, again, there's a great exchange of ideas as
there
well
is.
That goes on.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
We even sit around a big table that we painted with chalkboard paint.
Mm-hmm.
You can write ideas on it. You can make faces. You can say, I'm pissed off. I can't do this anymore.
Right.
You're angry at God.
Mm-hmm.
You're angry at the disease. You're angry at the system, because it's very hard for people to understand what
wow.
you're going
yes,
through.
Yes, absolutely.
Down to the doctors, to the
mm-hmm.
friends, and then you end up isolating yourself.
Yeah.
There's no need for that.
Mm-hmm.
We are here for you. You can call us at 908-651-5625 or go to our website, livingdementia.net.
Very good. You did that well.
Thank you.
You took my job. I don't have to do anything now.
Oh, Mike, go ahead. Repeat it. You can repeat it.
All right. We're chatting with Darlene Tranquilli, Living Dementia, 308 Main Street, Hackettstown, 908-651-5625, livingdementia.net. Find them on Facebook. But if you are caring for someone who has even the very beginning form of dementia,
yes.
get some help now. Find out more. Living Dementia will certainly help you. And Darlene, thank you so much for stopping by this morning.
You're
we appreciate
welcome.
It.
Thank you for the opportunity.
And have yourself a great day.
You too, Mike.
Again, I'll have a little bit more information up. If you missed the contact information, that'll be up on our website a little later on today. Check it out, livingdementia.net. Fine thanks to Darlene Tranquilli for stopping by and chatting with us this morning.